Hi everyone, this class is about Ramjet engines. We'll see how the Ramjet engine works and how the Ram effect and Ram pressures are achieved and how we are achieving the exit velocity in terms of inlet and the exit temperatures, and what is the TS diagram for the Ramjet engines, and what are the advantages and the disadvantages of the Ramjet engines. So these things we will see in this class. First, let us discuss about the working principle of the Ramjet engines. So in working principle of the Ramjet engine is nothing but how we are achieving the Ram effect and also how the pressure rise is achieved when we are coming to the combustion chamber. So nothing but combustion. So the Ramjet engines are divided into different parts. So we have one thing called, this is called a conical spike. And this conical spike is divided into supersonic diffuser and subsonic diffuser. From here to here is subsonic diffuser. And from this region nothing but combustion chamber or combustion. And from here to here it nothing but nozzles. So in the Ramjet engines, we don't have any moving parts, so like turbine and compressors. So that is the main advantage of advantage and easy to design the Ramjet engines. So when the air enters into the Ramjet engines, so that is nothing but that is entering entering in terms of supersonic flow. It means the flow enters the Ramjet engine, that is nothing but in the supersonic conditions. So like Mach number will be greater than 1. So when the flow enters into the inlet via inlet in the supersonic conditions, since it is a supersonic flow, then the shockwaves are created between this inlet and this spike and this kind of the edge of the this our outer body. Then the normal shockwave, generally this used to be a normal shockwaves, and then when the flow passes through this shockwaves, then there will be very much higher pressure rise that is achieved because of this shockwave conditions. And this shockwave, because of this shockwave, there will be some losses as well. And beside the losses, we are able to achieve enough pressure rise for our conditions, which is required for the combustion, which is required for the combustions. And then once it is after passing through the normal shockwaves, and then which is coming to the subsonic diffusers, where further pressure rise is achieved. Because of the subsonic diffuser, further pressure rise is achieved. Then whatever the pressure rise we are achieving through this kind of process, that is nearly about 30. So we don't want that much higher pressure rise. Even if you take all the losses into account, we will have enough pressure rise which is required for before reaching the combustion chamber. So in the case of turbojet and all, we will be having 8 or 10 to 12 something. So here we are getting the higher pressure rise without any moving parts, nothing like a turbine and a compressor. So that is the main advantage in the case of Ramjet engines. So once it is coming to the combustion chamber, where the fuel will be injected through the fuel injector. So once it is coming, then fuel is injected, then the combustion starts. So once the combustion starts, and these are nothing but flame holders. These flame holders will help us to establish the combustion. So for achieving the stable combustion, and then the flame holders are much useful. So then the combustion, hot combustion, the combustion takes place, the hot combustion gases are finally escaping through the nozzles. So at the end of the combustion, there will be a higher pressure as well as temperatures. Then this higher pressure and temperature will be further converted into higher kinetic energy, which is passes through the nozzles. So here we once it is coming out of the nozzle, we'll be having the enough jet velocity, which is further helpful in developing the thrust for ramjet engines. So this is how the ramjet engine works, and we'll see what is meant by ram effect and ram pressure. The ram effect and nothing but the process of achieving the higher pressure rise by converting the higher kinetic energy into pressure. So that this energy transformation is called nothing but ram effect. Then the pressure rise achieved through this energy transformation, that is, we call it as ram pressure. So this is what about working principles. And the TS diagram, temperature entropy diagram, which is used in the ramjet engine, is similar to the turbojet engines. So here, just for the ideal case, ideal ramjet engines, where the pressure and pressure, that means especially stagnation pressure, is constant, and which is very much useful in determining the jet velocity. Now, because since the expansion as well as ram compression, both are this is a expansion and this is a ram compression takes place in these regions. So because of this, especially that takes place because by the isentropic process. Because by using we know the condition for the isentropic process, and by using the isentropic condition process and also the constant pressure along these lines and these lines, so help us to constitute these equations. P0 to y P1 equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 into M1 square. This isentropic relationship we know very well, and already we have developed these equations. And we know the inlet Mach number, nothing but inlet velocity. So once we know that, then we will be able to calculate this. And also by using the isentropic relationship, P03 by P4, that is for the third and the 4, that is the actual condition. So that for that also we can write this relationship. And from this we know one thing, that this P02 by P1 will be equal to P03 by P4. It means both this pressure and this pressure are equal, and this pressure and this pressure are in the same constant lines. Because of that reason, we are able to come to this conclusion, P02 by P1 equal to P03 by P4. So then from this, we are able to achieve for one more condition, that Mach number. That is, from this the equations, M1 will be equal to, that means inlet Mach number will be equal to exit Mach number. So then writing the Mach number equations, and then we are able to achieve the jet velocity. Jet velocity or exit velocity, nothing but V1 into P4 by square root of P4 by P1. So that is nothing but static temperatures. These two are nothing but static temperatures of the exit and the inlet. So this is how we are achieving the jet velocity through the ramjet engines. And this is the thrust equations for finding the thrust, how much thrust is developed by the ramjet engines. So nothing but it is ME. ME is nothing but mass flow rate at the exit conditions into VJ. VJ or VE, that is exit velocity. This mass flow rate at the exit will be a combination of mass flow rate of the air and the mass plus mass flow rate of the fuel. So here we have to take that into account. And this is MI, you know, this mass flow rate at the inlet into inlet velocity plus P PE minus PA, PI, that jet exit pressure minus inlet pressure into AE, nothing but area of the nozzles. So area of the exit section, nothing but nozzle. So this thrust equation helps us to solve help us to find out the thrust developed by the ramjet engines. So this is what about working principle and thrust equations and also jet velocity. And now we'll see about the advantages and the disadvantages of the ramjet engines. So in the case of advantages, the main advantage is nothing but it is very simple. This device is a very simple device, nothing but this propulsion device is a very simple propulsion device, and it is easy to produce, design and produce, because of it doesn't have any moving parts. So that is one of the major advantages. And another advantage is this is very easy to maintain also, because since it doesn't have any moving parts, so it is very easy to maintain, and also it may not require a frequent maintenance operations. So and then another advantage is since it doesn't have any moving parts, this ramjet engine allow us to reach up to 2000 degrees Celsius. In the case of turbojet engine and all, we'll be able to go up to 900 degrees Celsius only. But in the case of ramjet engines, we are allowed to go up to 2000 degrees Celsius. So that is very much useful, and because of that reason, there is no any limit for the exit conditions. So it can go go to the very high velocity, nothing but higher Mach numbers. So it can fly at a very higher Mach numbers. The exit velocity will be at a very higher Mach numbers. And so that is another advantage. And then the specific fuel consumption in this case significant, especially at higher velocity and higher altitudes. So in those conditions, the specific fuel consumption will be much better compared with the turbojet engines. And then in the case of disadvantages, this engine has one major disadvantage, nothing but this engine cannot develop static thrust. It means at the standstill condition, this engine cannot produce any thrust. So no, since there is no static thrust, and this engine will not work at the ground condition, it means at the standstill conditions. It requires an additional propulsion device need to be carried to certain extent. Once it reaches the supersonic flows at the inlet conditions, then this engine will start to work. So that is how this engine works. That is a major disadvantages in the case of ramjet engines. And this engine works only in the higher Mach numbers, especially Mach number Mach number 2, then this engine, ramjet engine, is much efficient. Below the Mach number 2, the engine will not be much efficient. So that is one of the disadvantages. So this is what about ramjet engines. And we'll see how to solve the numericals by using these equations and also using the thrust equations. So that will be discussed in the coming classes. Thank you.